We're back with more of our countdown to Tokyo.
Of course, we cannot wait to see the athletes back in action, but let's be honest, we want to dig into the food, and we really want to just take a bite of Japanese culture and cuisine.
Here to show off her favorites is Japanese travel and culture writer Candice Kumai. She's also the author of Kintsugi Wellness. Candice, good morning. You think of all the great food in Japan, your sashimi, your sushi, your udon, your ramen. Talk to us. What do you have for us today?
Good morning. You guys are all so bright and shiny already. I used some. These are cool. In Japan, we love starting the day with a noodle dish, whether it's hot or cold. So this one's called hiyashi chuka or hiyashi men. Okay. And you can pair it with a ginger vinaigrette. And what you do is you just pour it right.
I want that.
And this one is cold, Candice?
Hiyashi chuka, or a cold ramen noodle bowl, which is delicious. And then to pair it off, I know you guys want to talk cocktails this time. The Japanese are known for artisanal whiskey, which has been made since 1923. So this is a toki that I'm putting in, which is light and fresh. This is the ultimate Tokyo drink called a highball. So this is just seltzer water right over. And that's it. Come by. So, good morning, Bev.
Good morning to you. Okay, so the noodle dish, you said that can be served at breakfast, lunch, or dinner. You can eat that anytime?
Yeah, you know, it gets so hot in Hawaii and in Japan, so we love our cold noodle dishes. Most ramen, soba, somen can be eaten hot or cold. So I love making these dishes. This next one is a soba noodle salad. So this one is made with spicy peanut sauce. You just pour over a little bit of sesame seed on top. And if you're in the mood for a good pairing, when it's a spicy dish, I prefer making a martini with that. So
why not?
This is hilarious.
Is it too early?
Noontime somewhere.
Exactly.
13 hours ahead in Japan.
We're late, technically.
Matcha powder and a Japanese haku rice vodka. It's made out of 100% rice. It also is made with koji, which has that umami back end to it. So to make a matcha cocktail, you whisk the vodka with the matcha.
Yes,
you do. And then you place it in a shaker with a little elderflower liqueur or vermouth, and then you give it a good shake. And then when your friends arrive, you can wow them with your green, sparkly martini.
I can't wait till we do the studio again.
I want to taste that.
Why do you think ramen is such an important part of Japan's food culture?
You know, my mom is from Kyushu, which is the mecca of ramen. And what we love about it so much is that it is so filling and comforting. You can put anything on top of it. It's very versatile. It's inexpensive. And it's been part of our history and culture for hundreds of years. Due to the war, the Japanese needed a filling, cheap, fast, easy food. And ramen really became it. So the other thing, popular to contrary belief, is that ramen is either instant or cheap. But really, it's, to me, it's the ultimate comfort food. What you want to do if you're making your ramen noodles is make them a la minute, meaning to the minute. And then you ladle your hot soup. In this case, this is a meat ramen.
That's so good.
By the way, just very impressive watching you direct yourself and do it.
Your own camera
so much confidence. Now, is it true or false? It's okay to slurp your ramen in Japan.
Very, very good question. So my mother would tell you it's polite in Japanese culture to slurp your ramen. It's saying to the chef, this is oishi, which means delicious in Japanese, and that it tastes good and you're enjoying it. So it's one of the old cultures that promotes the slurp.
Okay. There you go. Candice, thank you so much.
Thank you, Candice.
Great stuff. Thank you. For those recipes, you can head to today.com/food.